Join us online at charlierose.com.
I love bringing an inanimate object to life. And as you know, so many of my movies and even my short films are kind of about that. One of the things I always do is study the object. I study the object and thinking about, you know, what is the object what that we're bringing to life. And one of the first things you do as you identify and bring a character to life is figure out where the face is of a character. Because that is a window to the soul of the character. That's where you get a lot of acting from. Mm-hmm. And because if you move a character with just the head kind of moving with the body, it looks robotic. But as soon as you kind of lead the head with the character, it starts looking like it's thinking. That's the goal of character animation, to make an object look like all of its movements are generated by that character's own thought process. Mm-hmm. You want to make the hands of the animator just invisible. You want these characters to come alive on the screen. So by putting the eyes in the headlights, that means the face is down right in the front of the character, and the whole body is laid out behind it, and it becomes very awkward for the animator. You know, you don't have in that makes sense if you're doing a movie like Herbie, the Love Bug, or something like that, where there's a secret life of a car and there's humans mm-hmm. driving the cars. In our case, we decided we're not going to have any humans in this movie, just cars being alive. And so we moved the eyes up into the windshield. There was one of my favorite Disney cartoons back from the early 50s. It's called Susie the Little Blue Coop, which was animated by some of the great Disney animators. And they moved the eyes up in the windshield. And what it does is it gives the entire car body, it becomes the head, and it's nicely placed over the four tires, so it becomes a little bit more like the four-legged character. Mm-hmm. And so it gives the animators much more opportunity to give life to the character in a way. It makes the whole body kind of the character. But what's interesting also is that as we started animating the cars, we had these test cars early on in the development of the movie, the animators started really bending the cars around. And one of the things that I always do is I was excited about the idea of doing cars as characters in our medium of computer animation, because I knew that we could make the chrome look like chrome, the metal flake paint look mm-hmm. like metal flake. We could really make it look like it looks almost real. As soon as you started bending that too much, it looks like a metal car. That's, we all know metal cars are rigid, right? And it was looking like that, but then it was bending, and all of a sudden it did not have the integrity of the object. And so that's why we went back and really kind of rethought how we were going to animate it. And so if you really watch the movie, they don't bend a whole lot. They're pretty much rigid, but they bounce around on the suspension a lot. And we developed a whole technology to make it so as the cars rolled, the rolling of the wheels, the turning, all that stuff. It was the physics of a real automobile was put into this. We could change the weight of the car. We could change even the air pressure, the spring. And so we actually changed these per character to help give personality mm-hmm. through the way these moved.
Join us online at charlierose.com.